he's thrown something and he doesn't know that it's coming, he's probably going to be able to catch it.
The beauty of variety, which is what Bert excelled in, was that you never quite knew what was going to happen. There was the danger of live television on those shows.
And Bert had that incredible demeanour of also maybe making you think that things were going off the rails a little bit, and then having an amazing line or an amazing moment or the amazing ability to pull everything back. And I think that's why he was great, but it's also why he felt so comfortable watching it.
You know something, Mr. Lane?
If I knew something, would I be standing here with you in a hunchback outfit?
Girls. Girls won't go out with me.
Girls won't go out with you? Well, why do you think that is?
I think it's because I haven't got a car. I don't see you in my eye anymore.
That's not very funny.
The bad news is, that was a good one.
You had people like Don Lane, who was a fantastic performer, and you had Graham, who was out there in a league of his own for so long. But in amongst all that, there was that ensemble. But in that ensemble, there was Bert, who took everything to a new level.
I've got lots and lots of nieces and nephews, and I know how to do this, and I can give you some fun if you'll stay there. Now, you watch this. Now, hit me and say, get up.
Get up!
I reckon those two young guys thought it was the world's greatest lark. They had everything to gain by having a laugh and having a go, and basically nothing to lose, because they weren't risking a legend. They weren't legends by then. So they might as well have just let it all hang out and go for it. And if it worked, well, happy days. And if it didn't work, well, you know, they'd go back to what they're doing before.
Carl, would you mind getting in the bath for me? Carl. You've got a sign, I'm sorry, Graham.
Right, I'll get out.
Why are you wearing that?
Well, I've got to help out.
But I haven't got one.
Yeah, but that's a crummy dinner suit.
Carl.
May I have the top end?
Top end?
I'll take it.
That's it. He's a good...
Oh, hello.
Nice. Oh!
Hello again.
You can use plenty of it. Don't be frightened. Dogs love it. Yes. Oh, that's a boy. Oh, look at that. Yeah.
That's lovely, Carl.
Come on, Carl, you
more
dog. There.
Sit. Oh, pardon me. Sit. Oh.
I think generosity is a huge part of Bert's legacy, and I think his generosity came from a place of he's a fan. He's a fan of funny stuff. He's like, at his heart, he clearly loved funny people and funny things, and it meant the world to him.
Poor Bert Newton, since I shampooed him last week.
Oh, what a bad thing.
Look how good he looks. His coat is shiny. His little nose is moist.
Yeah, it is too.
And he finds it damn near impossible to go past a tree without...
Shut up, don't. That's disgraceful. By the way...
Shut your big face!
No, it's Mrs. Fisher.
Oh, no, wasn't that funny last week in the bath?
It was hilarious. You must have had a ball, did you?
I'm not saying anything.
It didn't sell very much dog shampoo, but we've had 56 inquiries from people who want to bath me.
And three of them were from girls.
There's that lovely dance that goes on, and you see that with Lane, and you see that really with, absolutely with Kennedy. Those two are dancing together beautifully.
It's meant to look easy, and it should look easy, and hopefully it's a lot of fun to do for the people that are doing it, but it's completely unique to the two people that are doing it.
People may not realise just what a great gift that is. That's a skill. It's a skill, though, that's been honed after thousands of hours.
I can't get it out.
I'll get it out for you.
Right.
You've got to breathe in.
Oh,
you've got to get that.
That almost kills you, doesn't it?
Yeah, there you are.
Oh, that's better. Thank you.
I'll just move this pussy.
OK. I always carry this with me, you know, because you never...
Oh, good. Yeah. It won't fit through the hole.
Why don't you go first?
Yes.
And then try.
Oh, that's a good idea.
You right?
Yep.
No?
Well, I have to put it over
here. OK, right. Well, just leave it. Yeah, right. You know, you never know when those nasty flies and monkeys... What have you done?
I've got to move the big can of pussy because of the next act.
Well, can I help you?
No, just go ahead and do that.
Where do you have to stick it?
Over there.
Well, get across there. Well, I'll talk about protecting.
Right. Yeah. Okay. I won't disturb you, mate.
Okay, right.
Go ahead and do the thing, you know.
As I was saying, I always carry Johnson's protector because you never know when flies and mosses will strike, particularly... This is the important part of the commercial because, you see... That's the catch there. Watch it squirt.
Wow! Like that!
There's not many things that are live to millions of people the way that Bert and people of that ilk were performing.
Kennedy makes an offer, Bert will never say no to it. You know, that's the key to all successful improvisation.
Anchorfill stores wet in the container, a handy plastic glove box pack.
May I pull mine out?
I wish you would.
See, I've got one too.
He has one, yes. His is the same size as mine.
Hey, wait on, mine. Mine stretches.
Yes.
Doesn't it?
So I've heard. Listen, around the Commonwealth, I would say. It's irrespective of race, creed, or colour. Here's Herbie. Lock up your door. Listen, it stays wet.
It does.
I hate this. I'm not going to do it. It stays wet in this pack, which means you can carry it in your glove box.
That's right.
Ready, ladies and gentlemen, for instant use.
Funny thing you should mention that.
Yes.
Anchorfill feels like a chamois. It looks like a chamois.
It smells like a chamois.
But performs and lasts better than natural chamois.
And Anchorfill does not become slimy or develop an odour... Anchorfill does not become slimy or develop an odour unless, of course, you do.
Well, I'm too old, Andy. Don't say oyster eyes because I get very...
You haven't got oyster eyes.
Do the stuff.
Yeah, fish eyes. 10 years ago in IMT, we introduced a brand new product to the market on television, Ral Merton shoes. They've been very kind to us over the years, Ral Merton. That's the shoe that you saw and perhaps wore in 1957. There's been a great change in the last 10 years. Have a look at this one. See the change? A great change.
That's a lot different.
Yes, that's amazing, isn't it, what they've done?
Well, look at the difference.
Oh,
that's
yes.
Tremendous.
Which is the one that's...
That's the one.
And this is the new one?
This is the new one. That's the old one.
Oh, you can see what's happened there.
What's that?
Nothing very much.
No.
I see a great future for me in this bottle. It's a bottle of RC. A big future for you too. I see romance. RC will be responsible for bringing many people together.
None of us see a big future for this character, Herbie, I think.
I liked the boy.
This must have been in the late 50s, early 60s. He's doing a sketch with a comedian, Tivoli musical comedian called Joff Allen. And Joff's dressed up as a grotesque parody of a woman. So he has balloon breasts and a skirt and is carrying a baby. And Bert, in character, is interested in the baby. He goes, oh, that's very interesting. He goes and looks at the baby.
What a gorgeous little baby.
And suddenly one of Joff's breasts bursts. And the laugh from the audience is, it seems to go like for 3 minutes. It is a huge laugh. It's one of the, touted as one of the biggest laughs ever on Australian television. And I rewound it and I thought, well, how did the thing burst? And as Bert goes in to look at the baby, he has a pin in his hand. So he's the one who sets it off. And the response is such that Bert, as the actor, has nothing to do with it. And he's stepping back and just can't believe what's happened. And Joff sort of just standing there, allowing the laugh to wash over him. It's his laugh.
I'd met Bert before I really had an appreciation of just how much he'd done, because there was decades and decades of work. And obviously he's not the kind of person that meets you and hands you a YouTube link to his greatest hits. So for somebody young, you know, we're 40 years apart. When you meet somebody 40 years your junior, I guess it's on the junior to go and research what you've done, because it is still, to me, an unfathomable amount of work.
Your Majesty! Don't sneak up on me like I dropped all my dinner, frightened hell out of me. Pick up my dinner.
Your Majesty.
Pick it up again. Pick all my dinner up. Pick up my dinner. Pick that up at once. Our king is talking.
If you don't pick that up, Bert, you won't be in the next series.
Without you.
Without me, Gary?
Bertie. Without you,
I'm nothing.
Without you, I'm nowhere. Without you, my life is stormy. And old pal, I've got no doubt. Without you here fighting for me, they're gonna count me out.
Oh! Without you, all my kicks are gone.
Say, without you, I just can't go on.
The moon won't shine.
And the day won't dawn.
Without who?
Without you, I'm zero.
Without you, I'm minus. Without you, true well goodbye.
I've got bitter tears and sorrow.
I think I'm gonna cry.
Hey, without you, lover, I'm the least.
Hey, without you, beauty, I'm the beast.
I'm dead.
He's gone.
I'm gone.
Deceased. Without who? Without you.
Without you.
Without you.
Without you.
Without you.
Without you. Without you.
Attachment parenting means connecting with our child in the most calm, loving and sweet voice.
I know that you want your own cutlery. What? Are you going to share?
It takes all kinds of parents.
Free range.
There are no rules.
Tiger!
I always set the goal high.
To raise our next generation.
I'm trying to protect them from everything.
But what kind of parent are you?
Our style is routine and structure with a lot of love thrown in.
Snails!
AJ's batted out the table, which isn't great manners. You should spit it in the serviette like his dad did.
In Chen Mind's next groundbreaking experiment.
Did any of you eat some of the decorations?
No.
Find out what you're doing right.
I'm asking, can they read and write?
They will read when they are ready.
And what you're doing wrong.
I am about to flip my lid, kid.
New parental guidance starts Monday on 9.
You can't reason with evil, son. Won't stop until it's one or you kill it.
There's a war going on in this valley. Today's the day you choose sides.
Hey, you're John Dutton, aren't you?
Yep. Oh, my God.
Right and wrong, good and evil. There's no such thing.
Don't you die on me now.
The brand new season of Yellowstone premieres November 8, only on Stan.
Victoria, 80% double vaccinated, is our ticket to safely getting back to the things we've loved and missed. Our ticket to seeing friends and family, to shopping in real life, to movies and live music that's actually live, to getting our shred on, our love on, and our masks off outside. But please wear one when you can't keep your distance. Your vaccination is your ticket. Find out more at coronavirus.vic.gov.au. Authorised by the Victorian Government, Melbourne.
Whether you're a sauce maker like Tran and Han, or a chocolatier like Dennis and Kylie, who covers thousands of businesses just like yours, Amy does.
Lucky, you're with Amy.
Be a tit out. That's all my eyes can see. Victory is mine. Yeah, surprisingly, I've been laying, waiting for your next mistake. I put in work and watch my status escalate.
Now I'ma start collecting props, collecting plots.
If you have the will, we have the way. Bank of Melbourne.
The Neds Punters Toolbox, fully loaded for Melbourne Cup Day. Take it to the Neds level.
And Felix the fish asked Daphne the dolphin for directions. Oh no, said Felix. I never learnt dolphin.
Fantastic furniture. Find your fantastic.
Master Foods has had a makeover. What great flavour looks like. Master Foods.
Dress-ups was never anybody other than Bert, but the great thing about it was that, and we were all expecting it. Like, it would have been slightly disappointing if Bert had just come out in a suit, and you could kind of work out what Bert might be doing because of the guests that were on the show that led up to the wheel segment.
Moonface, you go. Where's your... Here you go. All right, come on.
Thanks.
Debbie, let me take you away from this trash. Come with me. That was not.
As a kid, you'd used to beg Mum and Dad, can we stay up for the wheel to see what Bert was going to do next? You know, he'd come out and take the absolute mickey out of Kiss, for example. He'd come out as Gene Simmons, you know, the hottest band in the world, and Bert would come out and would just make it so funny. Recoiled at the term second banana to Bert. It's like saying here's the banana and a banana cake. If without the banana, there's no cake. He was absolutely fantastic. So yes, Don and of course Graham Kennedy were the stars of their shows, if you like, but it would have been a lonely experience for them if they weren't bouncing off somebody like Bert. But it wasn't just like he was the fall guy or the straight man. Bert was his own life force.
What's the matter with you? Are you okay? No!
From where I sat, it was clear to me that that's what drove him on screen, is just wanting to have fun and being willing to surrender to something that might go in a lot of different directions.
I can introduce you to a nice lady named Ivy.
Hi.
It's Ivy. It's Mrs. Ivy Sharab. Call her Ivy, and she's very good up against the back fence.
Oh, you are.
What is the matter with you?
You don't like the show anymore, do you? Is that it? You just want it in the toilet. You're just taking care of it.
Say hello to Ivy.
I love my sister.
Do you?
I really love her. I love her so much I can't say.
No, no.
That was really Bert's segment, wasn't it, the wheel? I mean, he'd come out dressed as Demis Roussos or, you know, something. He'd just turn it into something because it was towards the end of the show and it was sort of nearly time to go home and he probably figured everyone watching at home had had a few drinks and so, you know, they'd forgive him if something went wrong or they'd laugh more because we always laugh more when we've had a few drinks.
Ever and ever, forever and ever you'll be the one.
Then the wheel segment comes around and Bert comes out. He was identical to Demis Roussos. Right? I was probably wearing one of Demis's caftans. And it was funny, and he was singing forever and ever, and I think someone up in the sound booth was cranking up the echo, and it. And but Bert could hit the high notes. He does that. That's funny enough. And then Demis actually comes out.
Ever and ever, and ever and ever, and yeah!
And they're looking right at each other, and you see how identical they look. The line we all said around the schoolyard the next day was Bert's, which was, "Hey, he looks like me."
Crazy. You know what happened?
You sound like him.
Like me. It's Moonface.
There's a generation of people who don't remember Bert on live television. But for the people who remember In Melbourne Tonight and Graham Kennedy and the Don Lane show and the rarity of live television then.
In the early part of the century, the Titanic sank with a loss of 340 passengers. There were 97 survivors. Name them.
Oh.
fleecy cloud may kiss the sky, the rose may kiss the butterfly, the morning dew may kiss the grass, and you, my friend...
Fleecy cloud may kiss the sky, the rose may kiss the butterfly, the evening mist may kiss the grass, and you, my friend, good health.
He was always looking for where it might go spectacularly wrong and how he might correct it. Bert could see around corners. He could manufacture a punchline if things were going, you know, really badly.
And you can tell this and just in the way Bert presents, and it's usually in a live television context that you see this. And even if you're watching it on tape, you know that at that moment there's this kind of electricity in the air.
Clearly the best moments of watching Bert were times where, as a viewer, you're thinking, this is, you know, we might be in uncharted territory here, we're not sure where this is going.
Wagga wagga nala nala.
To get yourself in meditation, you have to say wagga wagga nala nala viola crumble rooty hill.
Wagga wagga nala nala viola crumble rooty hill.
But one must be in the snapdragon position.
What's the snapdragon?
As against the lotus position.
Okay,
this is... Must always check very carefully.
Wagga wagga nala nala viola crumble rooty hill.
What about your foot? I cannot move. I will tell you when, honorable brother. If you play it too early, I will come up there and fracture your skull with my hammer.
You're not a swami. What are you?
Not a swami.
No.
No, I bathe every day.
You're a mammy, aren't you?
You must put one leg up like so. Are you with me? Would you please put one leg up like so? Do you mind?
Yes, I do.
You know something, sir? You turn me on. Now, this is snapdragon now, and you put other leg over yonder. Now, through there. Now we start. Okay? You know what to say, don't you?
I'd like to announce the series cricket.
Sunday goes sky high. 60 Minutes takes off with the flying kangaroo inside the incredible fight to get back in the air.
Did it make you angry?
It made a lot of people angry. How do you allow that?
And his first Australian interview, Daniel Craig leaves Carl shaken.
Oh, no, you need to stop.
And stirred.
This interview's getting a bit uncomfortable.
Thank you very much.
Tonight.
More online business.
More collaboration.
More fibre upgrades. NBN, made for more.
I think customers have a great idea of Bunnings is about. They come here, they know what they're going to get, and they know they're going to get it at the lowest price.
Aqua 20-metre hose reel, great value at only $44.89. Stanley tool chest and trolley combo, $389. 18-volt hammer drill kit, an amazing $39.
Where you find a competitor's lower price on the same stocked item, we'll beat it by 10%.
Bunnings' philosophy is simple. We have the widest range at the lowest prices.
Bunnings Warehouse!
Lowest prices are just the beginning.
Tired of running out of sparkling water? Then get this counterbalance forklift. It can carry truckloads, so you never run out. There must be a fresher way. Oh, get a soda stream and make fresh sparkling water at home whenever you want.
It's Melbourne Cup Day and it's time to play. On races 1-4 at Flemington and Randwick, place a tote win bet and if your horse runs second or third, get a bonus bet back up to $50. Tab, long where we play.
Gamble responsibly.
This past year has felt like a long Norwegian winter. But with spring comes rebirth. Welcome back to the world.
Book now and save up to $8,000 with Viking.
At NextSense, we believe everyone should be able to live life to the fullest. We've been working with people with hearing and vision loss for over 160 years. Together, we're redefining what's possible.
Your floor. You'll see it every day from a new perspective. Sometimes you won't even know it's there. Quick Step Floors, the start of something beautiful.
Want more freedom? Right now with Metricon, the first 25 buyers can get this two-story Bentley 34 home for just $298,900. That's freedom by Metricon.
Should have gone to Specsavers. Get free standard multifocal lenses.
By strengthening the security settings on her device, Denise is resisting the advances of deceptive cybercriminals trying to steal her personal online information. Go, Denise. Beat cybercrime in your downtime. Learn the easy steps for protecting yourself online today. Act now. Stay secure. Visit cyber.gov.au. Authorised by the Australian Government, Canberra.
When it comes to home loans, an Aussie broker is with you every step of the way.
I've been looking at some loans I think will be a great fit.
That's how we've helped over a million Aussies sign here. Go straight to Aussie.
Our parenting style is
tiger.
Tiger. Ying means to always set the goal high. Mimi, that part you're still not doing it properly. The year Mimi prepared for scholarship exams, I quit my job so I can have more time. I do demand perfection.
TV's next groundbreaking experiment.
No!
Parental Guidance starts Monday, 7:30 on 9.
Join multi-gold Logie Award winner Bert Newton and Patty in their very first show together. Ford Super Quiz.
Stopper $1,000, the money or the box?
The box.
You want the box? The box is yours and you have something very, very valuable. You have a Fitzroy Football Club bag.
Oh, who are you talking to? Maria?
My lover.
Any names?
I'm sitting next to her.
I'll tell you what, that'd be an arsehole shock for both of them, wouldn't it?
I said a top guest, not Rob guest. Swap stuff. I want to thank the various magazine publishers around Australia. It's been terrific to get their support. We really do appreciate, particularly the Bulletin, which is a pretty hard one to crack.
Claim to fame. I noticed in the background that you once shared a urinal with John Howard, the Prime Minister.
I did a few years ago.
Yeah.
I was hoping you wouldn't bring that up.
No, actually. That's okay.
But I do know why his nickname's Little Johnny Howard.
That's yeah. I'll do the tags if you don't mind.
How much of that hair's real, Bert?
Not very.
I'm going to say, that'll be my next go.
Let's have a look.
Thanks.
Yeah. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the great
thank you.
Question being asked of Dulcie is, how much water do we have on this earth of ours? Is it 25%? 50%? 7%? Or 100%. We ask for complete quiet and no helping.
50%. 75%. Or 100%.
Bert has a segment called New and Unusual Products, and he would come in with this massive suitcase and That was as welcome as the wheel segment, which was, of course, every week. But Bert had come on and slammed down the suitcase, open it up, and the delight was seeing what he was going to pull out.
Jason, careful, he hasn't been fed.
Come here, Jason, we're going to put you in your new home. You're going to love it.
Jason!
Jason, get in here. Come on in here. In here. Oh.
Things went rogue on him. That's when he was at his best. It was almost like, come on, throw something at me to see how I can react. You know, I've got the chops to do anything. Come on, give me something.
This wine should turn into water. We're going to do it the other way around, but somebody else holds the rights. Let's have a try. Now, this is ordinary wine, untouched, except by a couple of prop boys just before the show.
This is a real... Look, if you pour that into here, if you pour that into that glass, have a look at the colour of that, and you can't tell me that that's not filtered. Look at that. That's amazing. Even if it's only that colour, it's amazing.
Very true.
I mean, just look at the difference in the colour. If you got a colour in there like that...
Yeah.
Look at that. You can see the difference in that colour between what there is down there and the bottom of that. That's amazing.
You bet your bum.
I mean, if that... Look, just like the whole glass. If you get a full glass of that like that,
yeah,
right, that one, and you put that through that filter...
I got the sense that maybe he didn't know exactly what the product was or what it achieved, so that when Dom was asking him questions, he was just kind of making stuff up. And that felt quite real and in the moment.
What does this do? It's supposed to clean your face and your poison.
What it does, it cleans your face, and also it's wonderful for the eyes, Don. It's magnificent. One more time.
Last time, 7 seconds.
Okay. This is the last treatment, right?
All right, I'll count 7 seconds.
1, 2, 3. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
What is going on? Quiet time. The phone.
This is good fun, Don.
Is it? How hot is it? Ooh, warm.
Oh, very warm.
Nice. Yeah. You've got...
Hey?
You've got...
Could you hold these for me, please? Always wanted them, Don. Oh, that's so invigorating. Oh, it's just hitting the spot, too.
I have something similar to this.
I know. I've seen it.
Oh, I've been at home.
Don.
What?
Women and children first. Patty, if you're watching, she's doing dreadful things to me. Give her a ring and find out what she's doing. Oh, Donna, please. Donna, please. Donna.
Anyway, Bert, I thought you'd enjoy your...
What a way to go.
It's got 3 speeds.
Yeah.
Slow, yeah. Fast, and make a wish.
Right, we've got to that stage. Now back again.
Back again.
That's it. All right. Look at that.
$3,000 on hair transplants and bugger it in 1 minute.
Okay.
That was good, Don.
I like that. Yeah.
One button here.
Right.
I don't know what it does for your weight, but I think I'm in love.
Just stand up. Wait a minute.
Done.
Stay that way and we'll change camera angles.
Done.
Yes.
How's the hair?
Yes, I'm going to give you a normal coffee.
Oh, right.
Right.
And then after the normal one, I'll give you the coffee mate.
You're not going to put soap suds or anything.
I wouldn't do that. Can you see okay?
Yeah,
fine,
terrific.
Of course you can.
How many fingers am I holding up?
One with...
5.
That's it.
One
okay,
with
you got it.
Coffee mate. Right, and one ordinary coffee. Won't be a second.
Okay.
Here we go.
You're not really... You promise you're not doing anything funny?
Pardon? No, not for years. Okay. Here we go.
Patty can vouch for that, I can tell you that.
Mm.
Yeah, what do you think?
Okay, nice, yes.
You sure?
Very nice.
Is it really, really nice?
It tastes great, actually, smooth and creamy.
Well, that's the ordinary coffee. You shouldn't have said
that. My
we'll try this one now. This would be a good one.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Okay.
Where am I?
Right here.
You're
right
on Channel 9. You remember Channel 9, Don and Bert?
Yeah, Don and Bert.
There you go. Right.
Mmm, that's beautiful. Really smooth.
Is it even better?
Even better.
That's as translucent as the finest china, but it takes a lot of beating.
Ha,
beat
ha.
It. Show them how you can beat it.
Come estate. Je Bert. Vous Italiano? You want fun? Do what I do. Open up your Legos.
Falling in love again, never wanted more. What am I to do?
People in King's Cross would pay big money for this.
I've seen you there, darling.
Shut up.
Bert didn't take Don's singing that seriously. And I didn't buy Don's album, but Don was really trying to sell that album for, I seem to remember, a good 6 months. We wouldn't talk about that next day at school, but we would talk about Bert's version of the single, I think, off that particular album that Bert would attempt to do in very sincere and different versions.
It really is a magnificent record. It's on special now, $2.99.
It is not. Don't say that.
It's magnificent. He sings I Need... Oh, I tell you what I love you doing.
What?
She's out of my life. 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 Only know I love you so.
He only knows.
Why did I have to write this song?
I'm buggered if I know.
I don't know whether to live or die, 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 die. And it cuts like a knife. She's out of my life. Why?
So many people are unkind.
Don, they have that album back. I went to the trouble, Don, of gift wrapping one for Fook. I thought it might be nice as a Christmas present, so
yes,
there you are.
Fox Sing.
Yeah,
Fox Sing.
Yes. Yeah, gift wrapping.
Well, what if he wants it?
Well,
thank you
just
very much.
Open
yes.
on Christmas morning. You'll love
yes.
it.
Oh, hang on there. Just a second. Just a minute.
No, that's fine. I just thought I'd go.
No. I've worked with you for how many years now?
5.5 years.
Yeah, that's enough.
But it's folks.
No, just a minute. Just want to see something.
You.
Hang on a minute.
The most emotional thing for me today was to walk into the foyer of this hotel, and I kid you not, and please, as I say, I wish to remain modest. I had no less, I guess, than 150 people surge toward me, which was wonderful. I said to Jason and Carly, who came in with me, coming into the Crown foyer, there are 500 people there shouting and screaming and throwing things. I said to Ricky Martin, who was walking in with me,
me
Good evening, Alicia Loxley, updating Nine News. Tributes are continuing to pour in for legendary entertainer Bert Newton, who passed away at the age of 83. Bert's wife, Patty, has accepted an offer from Premier Daniel Andrews for a state funeral to be held at St Patrick's Cathedral. Troubled magpie Jordan DeGoey is facing assault charges after allegedly groping a woman in a New York nightclub. And Liberal MP Tim Smith has resigned from Shadow Cabinet after crashing his car while drunk. 23 and sunny tomorrow.
The sting of the year.
You've been stung, brother.
The mechanic who set a trap and the muscle man who fell for it.
You're that scammer, mate.
A driveway duster and a long walk of shame with nowhere to hide.
Why are you guys running away?
Go Current Affair.
The gotcha they never saw coming. A Current Affair Monday.
To protect one another. Toyota Safety Sense, designed to protect us all. Oh, what a feeling. Toyota.
Yeah, Kate, Tim and Joel, the Savo, turning up the feel good.
Have a look at this Nova boys here.
He doesn't have any pants on.
Is that a thing?
No, we don't either.
There's only one thing to look for. Choose a super fund with this symbol.
We're all in this together.
Irresistibly smooth chocolate. To put the world on pause. Lindor, made to melt you, by the Lindt Master Chocolatier.
I got three going at once.
I've got four. Add up to four runners to a same race multi and watch your potential payout increase.
Loud broke it this Melbourne Cup Carnival with a same race multi.
Tired of running out of sparkling water? Then get this counterbalance forklift. It can carry truckloads, so you never run out. There must be a fresher way. Oh, get a soda stream and make fresh sparkling water at home whenever you want.
Is that a barbecue?
The children's nook smells like cutlets.
It's okay. It was free delivery with Amazon.
Free delivery? That's impressive.
Got any vegan options?
Got corn.
Free delivery on millions of items. Amazon.com.au.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. From now on, all troubles will be miles away. And have yourself a merry...
Discover meaningful gifts for every story at Pandora.
That's Eileen, Kareem, Irene, with friend Eugene.
Green, apples, kids fruit free.
Who wants one?
Me!
Electricity, clean, green, live, all stores by 2025.
Fresh, steamed, string bean, mandarin,
protein,
chow mein.
Put it in a tureen.
Oh, hello, Mr. Goldstein.
That's today's fresh food, people.
Whatever your claim, big or small, we're on to it. Yui, you insured.
One of the best Bonds ever. Pierce Brosnan.
Name's Bond. James Bond.
GoldenEye. Tomorrow 8:40 on 9GEM.
Will. Always be bosom buddies, friends, partners and pals. We'll always be bosom buddies. If life should reject you, there's me to protect you.
And if I say that your tongue is vicious,
if I call you uncouth, it's simply that. Who else but a bosom buddy will sit down and tell you the truth? We'll always be good companions.
My china!
My mate. We'll always be harmonized.
Oh, I love that. Could we do that again? I loved it.
We'll always be harmonizing.
I think we better quit while we're ahead.
Here's Uncle Bert. Hello. Hello. This is only a microphone. Yes, he likes Ben, and no. Anyway, if my dry cleaner is watching, keep the secret.
Every performer would look at Bert and go, that level of comfort, that level of ease, that level of like natural ability, that's the rare air that I think he occupied pretty much by himself.
He wouldn't affect the hair transplants, would he? Wouldn't. There you are. Oh, hasn't he got sharp claws?
Yes.
Oh. Would you mind sitting down, Graham? Because you don't realise, apart from my doctor, Peachy is the first person to touch my hair in 5 years. Now, Peachy, take him very gently, will you? Because it's right where some plugs are. Peachy, there you go. Peachy, please. Here, Peachy. Oh, Peachy. No, there you go. There you are. Oh.
That's the great thing about live TV. In a world now that's always looking for perfection, where there's none, Bert was able to just adapt. So when Don, as clearly the host, and it was a big deal because they had all these entries and TV Week, and I'm sure the sales department were all over him.
It's just terrific. This is Max who set this up, folks.
The front office brass would have said, oh, this is a huge night for us. So Don just wants everything to go well, and of course it doesn't work.
Max, don't do that without the net under it. Hold it. Leave it alone, Max. Max, leave it alone, Max. Really, leave it alone. Leave it alone. I got a better idea.
As it turned out, they had more entries, so they couldn't get the hinges to spring. And of course that's perfect for Bert, as the more that Don blew up, the more that Bert took over.
Hang on, come here. This corner. Max, leave it alone, Max! Max, leave it alone!
Bert stepped in like the everyman that he was. He was the viewer. Bert was everyman. He was who we were at home, but he was a lot cleverer than us because obviously he, you know, that was his shtick.
I've seen Bert do this a lot of times where you just see the twinkle in his eye go and you just sit there waiting.
Just in case you've just tuned in. We're having fun on the late show. You might remember the Debbie Lesnar promotion we had. Well, we've got to net the one open. You missed a tremendous time. Okay, Bert has gone berserk. Don's furious. And Debbie's bewildered. Go back to the film and watch tomorrow's papers. We'll let you know what happens. No, wait a minute, Max. I don't want... Score at the moment, Don Lane, Max Morrison, line ball. I think we'll go to a commercial break. We'll come back and we'll give you the latest score. No, come here. Come here, Max. And come straight back.
Give me the net, please.
Give you the net? Yep, certainly, Don.
Don was obsessed with the afterlife and he would have Doris Stokes on and it was all very serious and you kind of felt that Don needed these people on, you know?
No, son, it's your mum, because she said you were her baby, and she hasn't been over all that long, my darling, has she? Because it's only a tiny light.
Yes.
And she said, don't worry about me, love. You're grieving because you weren't there.
Yes,
at the
right.
End. Well, don't grieve, because I'm here. I'm alive.
He also had James Randi on, who was a great debunker of this sort of thing, and I think Don took great exception to what James Randi was saying about Doris Stokes.
You go against a lady like Doris Stokes, who never harmed anybody in her whole life, and you call her a charlotte and a fake.
You know a great deal about it.
Yes, I do. You said that she was a liar on the radio. No. You called her a liar.
No.
And that woman would lie to anybody. And I don't know whether she's right or wrong, but she would lie to anybody. We're going for a commercial break, and you can piss off.
Oh, Oddly enough, when that particular clip was featured in a compilation that Bert was hosting, Bert offered his own. He said, "Oh, it was a very interesting moment. James, in fact, finished the rest of the show. Dodd never came back." Later on in the show, there was another guest, Martha Gardner, I think, coming on talking about cleaning products.
Would you like to be our first guest?
You know what to say, do you?
I was terrified that you weren't happy with Martha Gardner's wool mix. Martha, I tried your wool mix on the weekend. Martha, piss off!
Channel 9 was inundated with people complaining about Don's language, but no one mentioned that Bert had said exactly the same thing about 20 minutes later.
The notion of saying piss off was not something that Australians had never heard before. And Bert was saying what they felt. That was his genius, that he would know what they were thinking at home and he would say that.
Bert was able to come in and diffuse the whole situation by showing that it wasn't that big a deal and the fun that was involved in it, and took the heat out of the whole thing.
A wonderful Royal Charity performance in London featuring John Lennon being very cheeky to Her Majesty. You know, he's going to come on, everyone clap along, and the rest of you could rattle your jewellery. And that's it's a cheeky moment, goes down very well with the audience, and he gives a sort of a little sheepish grin. It's a similar moment in Bert's career where he did a Royal Charity performance.
From me, welcome to you, particularly members of the Fitzroy Football Club. And members of the Rooty Hill RSO. As I mentioned to you, tonight is for charities in New South Wales. We've done a very quick audit at the door, and there are still two people who haven't paid. Now, I beg your pardon, no.
Clearly cared about having fun in the moment. That was a huge lesson that I learned from Bert. It really doesn't matter what you've done if you're a performer, it's about what you're doing.
I mean, Bert rode in on an elephant. That's, no one does that anymore. You know, if they have a criticism about television these days, no one rides an elephant.
TV's next groundbreaking experiment.
This is going to change the conversation about parenting.
We'll put Aussie parenting to the ultimate test.
Yeah. We want to love our children and see them grow.
Three nights a week, over three unmissable weeks.
I am about to flip my lid.
Alison Langdon and Dr. Justin Coulson. New parental guidance starts Monday, 7:30 on 9.
We're almost there, Australia. Book your vaccination at australia.gov.au. Authorised by the Australian Government, Canberra.
Special K. Rise with us. Rise with protein for muscle. Rise with iron for energy. Set goals, then kick them. Special K, powering you.
Three tyres.
Like a blended bet on the Ladbrokes app.
You get more winning chances in the same race.
Ladbroke it this Melbourne Cup carnival with a blended bet.
The McSpicy range. It's already game over. Even the word spicy has your mouth tingling with anticipation for that almighty burn. The only question is, can you handle the heat? Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
The laser on Dyson's latest vacuum reveals invisible dust, and carbon fibre filaments remove it. Here's scientific proof. By Direct, from the people who made it.
With festive sleepwear from $14 at Best & Less, Christmas is going to be all bright.
Head is all good.
The MG HS mid-sized SUV. More space, more safety tech with MG Pilot, and more peace of mind. All from only $29,990 drive away. The MG HS. It's the more you've been looking for.
Whatever your claim, big or small, we're on to it. Yui, you insured.
Can dream it, you can build it with GoDaddy. Whatever your idea, you can turn it into something real. When your passion becomes your purpose and you're ready to build your dreams online, we'll be there. Empower your business with GoDaddy.
The world and our international borders are now reopening, and it's time to reignite your love to travel in 2022 with the Scenic Grand Opening Sale. Experience five-star, truly all-inclusive luxury, unrivaled dining and enriching experiences as you cruise Europe's grand waterways. Book a 15-day scenic river cruise for $9,595 and fly business for $2,995. Total price $12,590.
To live is to ask the big questions like,
whoa, how fast was that serve?
That is fast.
Wow. How far was that drive? 229 meters? Are you taking an ECG here? And you're taking one here. Are you taking an ECG at a birthday party? Oh, hi. Wait, can you surf with that thing? Guess that's a yes.
The winner is Bert Newton. Bert, it's not often I yield a platform to a bloke to make a speech, but I think it's your turn, mate.
Thank you, Bob. Thanks very much. Thank you.
He is the Logies, as far as I'm concerned. My memory is that I don't remember anybody else hosting the Logies.
Owned the set, and he'd walk on, and he had the moves of a ballerina. He was just beautifully light on his feet. He glided through, and he'd walk on with his presence.
He knew what people in the room were thinking at the Logies. He knew exactly what was going on in that room, and it's the hardest room in the country to work. I mean, a room full of television people. Man, that's hard.
So this is 2001. And I've been asked for some unknown reason to host the Logies.
This is actually the first time I've appeared on Channel 9. And indeed, I don't often do commercial television anymore. The reason for this is, and I hope this doesn't sound arrogant, I just feel it's beneath me artistically. There's been a third rating system that's going to be introduced. We have a sneak preview of it here. It's just as accurate as Nielsen and Oztam. Here we go. Shall we see how we're doing tonight?
And I go into Channel 9, I'm in the old prefab fibro hut that probably Bert was in when he was in there hosting. And I say, well, can I have a look at all the Logies? I'm actually going to watch them all the ones you have. So they're all on VHS at that stage. And I watched every Logies.
Tonight we're very excited about the Logies because for the very first time, they're not fixed. No. The very first artist we have to introduce to you.
This card really says, I'm madly in love with you. Will you marry me, Loretta?
I really didn't know that this was going to happen. And I have an affliction. It's called emotion. And oh, shit.
Congratulations, mate.
There's no doubt if Bert Newton had have gone to America, he would have been one of the biggest acts in the history of show business around the world. He was of that class, and you saw it. You saw the big names when they came on Logie nights, just how, not they didn't defer to Bert, but they picked up pretty quickly that this was a guy who was actually a kindred spirit, somebody who was on their level.
Just explain to me, if you can, what's happening with Days of Our Lives at the moment. Now, I know My favourite character is Mickey. What's happened with Mickey?
What's happening with Mickey? Well, I think his amnesia has cleared up.
That's good.
Let's see, that came on after the stroke and the massive heart attack. He was in the hospital and just feeling a lot better after the triple bypass surgery.
I said, how many times have you been married in the series?
Well, I have this child, you see.
You have a child?
But that...
Out of wedlock?
Right, yes, quite.
Is he still living?
He's 27 years old now.
And obviously, he would have to be for the plot of Homosexual, is he?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, is he?
Yes.
Is he really? Is he
really? Well, nobody knows but his agent.
Best single documentary. Dear Tony, this is the only way I could get in touch with you.
You look great.
Thank you very much. Someone said to me the other day, there are three ages in life. Youth, middle age, and gee, you look great.
No matter who he was next to, whether it was Burt Lancaster or Muhammad Ali or somebody who was a bit drunk, it was Ed Devereaux, maybe he'd had a few too many drinks, Burt would be able to change the shape of the two of them. He'd move to either save somebody who maybe wasn't getting a laugh or wasn't in control of the situation, or if they were fine, he'd step back, like, say, he would do with Barry Humphries. He would just step back.
Lovely, and you're doing so well, Bert, you are.
Thank you, Dave, Adler, thank you.
Where's that lanky sidekick of yours?
He may be watching tonight, who knows? You're looking absolutely beautiful as always.
Aren't I, darling? Of course, women will be copying this frock slavishly, won't they? I wouldn't be surprised if it appeared in Canberra in a day or two. I wouldn't be surprised. I did.
Dave, Adler, the last thing in the world I'd like to do is to upset you in any way, but I'm just wondering if tonight a television set has been placed strategically in a hospital ward here in Melbourne for you to say hello to your beloved husband, who, of course, has not been seen publicly now for many, many years.
Well, I'm afraid Norm is dead, darling. He's... Please, that's terribly tasteless. Bert, that's sickening, isn't it? He's dead to the world.
Oh, I see.
People loved him and trusted him. They loved him as a conduit. They loved him as an entertainer. And he was our Bert.
I think that's why Bert's Bert, because he occupied those slots across decades. And I think that just deserves everlasting respect, because it's not like he did that similar to 10 other people in history. We just haven't had anyone do that. We're still so early into the history of television in that sense that he's occupied, you know, 90% of its lifespan.
It's all promotion now, advertising, getting it out there. I mean, in the old days, what we would simply have.
And that's why the Logies became what they became. Bert lifted them to a new level. When those people came to town, like John Wayne, the Duke, when he was the biggest act in the world.
When you talk about Hollywood, when you talk about movies, when you talk about stars, when you talk about greats, if you don't include this gentleman, you've never seen a movie. Mr. John Wayne.
Do that show every year and still keep you cool. I mean, all those big names, Raymond Burr, John Wayne, Charlton Heston, Muhammad Ali. I mean, it must be a nerve-wracking experience to meet a big star for the first time.
Well, if they get nervous, they get nervous.
And I know you'll know that I mean this when I do it. Here, pal, 6 months in your house and 6 months in mine. How's that, all right?
Is that Carmen? Carmen Van Hoogenhagen, Hegen, Hagen, Hoogenhagen, Hegen. She looks beautiful. Lovely. Don, how about 6 months in your place and 6 months in mine? I was doing the Logies all those years ago. It was much more simple. You just arrived on the day. You did a gag on Kamal. You insulted an American guest. Gave the gold to Graham Kennedy. And then spent most of the night avoiding going to bed with Molly Meldrum.
And I suppose some things never change. To introduce... Molly is actually kissing my wife, Patty, over there. A first for both of them. Well, there you go. I meant nothing by that. I love you, darling. And I'm very fond of you too, Patty.
From the moment we were, you know, young, 22, 23-year-olds, perhaps when we met him the first time, to the last time that we spoke, he's just a gentleman. He's a generous, he cares. He cares so much about the entertainment industry. And I think that's what ultimately gave him that longevity. He was still doing stuff because he loved it.
19 times Logie host and inductee into the Logies Hall of Fame, the legendary, some say mythical, Bert Newton.
That's absolutely wonderful. And good night. As a matter of fact, just before coming on, one of the crew said, you know, you're the oldest presenter on the stage tonight, which is a good start. But I think I might be the warm-up for the in memoriams. This won't take long. I left Channel 9 after 28 years, went back to Channel 7 for a year, and then I left television and went to Channel 10.
I mean, he had an extraordinary life, really, didn't he? What an extraordinary life to be able to say that you've worked with people of the calibre of, you know, Dean Martin and Sammy Davis Jr. back in the day when there weren't as many superstars even in Hollywood as there are now. And for that to just be, that was just his backyard, really, wasn't it?
Never a more worthy winner of the Hall of Fame Award than Bert Newton.
Bert knew what controversy was all about. And because he was such a giving performer, that night on the Logies when he came out and he told it as it was, from his point of view...
I want to let you know that the 16 or 17 years in which I compared the Logies, they were very important years to me. Times have moved on, television has moved on, but I would simply like to say that the 30 years I spent in television were the happiest 30 years of my 49 years so far.
He was able to come out and pointed out things, not in a completely over-the-top way, but just with enough sharpness, with enough edge, to make people just squirm a little bit in their seats.
I've been absolutely thrilled with the way in which I've been remembered by people today. It has been 3 years since I had the news broken to me by Patrice Fidgen from TV Week. I was no longer with the Nine Network.
He took it in a way that said, yes, thank you, I'm being magnanimous, and I'm honoured that I've been recognised in this way. But he also thought, right, OK, but there's a couple I want to just square up along the journey.
Such nice people running television these days. Remember the old days when we had creative people? Terrible days, dreadful.
It was great television. It was honesty, and I think that's the key to it. He delivered it with the panache that we know of Bert Newton. We saw all sides of him, I reckon, in that speech.
I think most people would agree that legend status is assessed by a complete view of somebody's actions. And for Bert, in the public eye, that's decades and decades of, you know, thousands and thousands and thousands of instances of doing things that I don't think anyone else could do.
I like the boy.
I like the boy is a quote of the old Warner Brothers cartoon character of Foghorn Leghorn, which is in itself a quote of an old radio program character called Senator Claghorn back in the late 30s, early 40s.
For months beforehand, Bert was always saying that line, I like the boy.
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 So when he said it, and then, of course, Don Lane twigged because he was American what was going on.
Did you say Roy or boy?
I like the boy. There's nothing wrong with saying that.
Roy.
Yeah. Hey, hang on. No. I'll change religion. I'll do anything for you. I don't care.
And then again, you saw that Muhammad Ali understood that there was no intention and that Bert genuinely didn't realise what was going on.
I mean, I like the man.
Yes.
Are we facing in the right direction?
Whatever you want to do, I don't care.
I'm sorry, Muhammad. No, it's okay. Listen, Joe, just in case, would you get... This is the...
I think the audience watching it knows that there's no ill intent and they know there's fun in it and they could see it from the way Ali and Bert are playing with each other. That's the thing you remember. That's the comic climate that's created. Bert's done that. He's created this comic climate where you receive the information, you receive everything that's said in that spirit.
...1978 Gold Logie winner, Bert Newton.
Your Sunday goes sky high. 60 Minutes takes off with the Flying Kangaroo.
It's exciting to see the country open up.
Inside the incredible fight to get back in the air.
Did it make you angry?
It made a lot of people angry.
How do you allow that?
The Aussie trapped in Baghdad hell.
We have an array of violations.
And his first Australian interview, Daniel Craig, leaves Carl shaken.
Oh no, you need to stop.
And stirred.
This interview's getting a bit uncomfortable. Thank you very much.
Next on Nine.
Still using corded power tools? Cut the cord and upgrade to Milwaukee M18 fuel. All the power you need on one cordless platform. Ensure it's backed by warranty by purchasing from an authorized Milwaukee retailer. Milwaukee, nothing but heavy duty.
Hey Google, pause. Hey Google, play Vivo on Netflix on the TV.
There you are!
No. Follow the chase from your kitchen, living room, or any room. Get whole home entertainment with Google Nest.
Three tyres.
Like a blended bet on the Ladbrokes app.
You get more winning chances in the same race.
Ladbroke it this Melbourne Cup Carnival with a blended bet.
We always believed the welcoming spirit was a small town thing. Turns out, we were wrong.
From the places that don't have a welcome sign, to the spots where you don't look the part, the moments where you don't even know where you are. Turns out, the world can be a lot more welcoming than you think.
This is on the telly.
Mommy!
There's a delicious way to lower your cholesterol, so you can keep one eye on your heart health and the other on the things you love.
Hi, sweetheart.
Start your day with Sultana Brand Plus with cholesterol-lowering plant sterols.
We can all achieve greatness. We get there by building to it. We start with that little something. A talent, an interest. And when we bring those things, they can be made into something great. Turning the caring into specialists, the curious into engineers, the determined into leaders. Show us what you've got, and we'll show you what you can achieve. What will you bring?
You are the prophecy of Wentworth. This is my prison. Bad habits lead to...
mother's prison.
No, 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 no.
I do.
You need to find the guts to do what you have to survive. Like every single one of these women has had to do.
We don't negotiate with prisoners.
Stream every episode of Wentworth now on Binge. At HCF, we define success as being the right type of inspiration. We provide free support to help you change your relationship with alcohol. Because we're not for profit, uncommon care is our bottom line. Join HCF today.
The block goes under the hammer. Who will win?
This is it.
And the photo cheat finally revealed. The grand finale next Sunday, 7 o'clock.
This is going to change the conversation about parenting.
New parental guidance starts Monday, 7:30 on 9.
Marriage is a lottery, but you can't tear up the ticket if you lose.
I've been married for 3 happy years. Ah, 3 out of 6 is not bad, is it?
Oh, is it? Does Bert snore?
Only when he's on his back.
They say behind every great man is a great woman. That's not the case. Alongside every great man in these situations, if it can work, you've got somebody like Patty. Patty was the ultimate performer in her own right, yet she didn't ever upstage Bert. The love that you could just feel generating and respect from one to each other was, it was quite touching to just see every single time. Yep, Patty loved Bert. She respected him as a performer, loved him as a husband and a father, but she was there. I mean, talk about staunch. Any time that anything was on, Patty was there. And Bert, you could tell, he drew great strength from that always.
Ah, thank you, Don, very much indeed.
Overseas in battle, when the postman came to me, Australia Post couldn't have been on strike. But when he handed me that letter, I was so doggone happy as I could be. You see, folks, the battle, it was over. The war had been won. So I opened up that doggone letter, and the beautiful little thing, you know how it started off? It started off, dear John.
Dear
Bert, for that generation of people, that's my generation of people, Bert's a founding father of television.
He did wonderfully as an MC or as a presenter of anything is that he'd take the audience by the hand and say, look, I think this is really good. You're going to have a really good time. Come with me through the curtain and we'll just see this great show.
Every night was opening night. Every night this was the biggest performance of his life. And when you sat at home, you knew that every time you turned on Channel 9 with Bert Newton, bang, showtime. Forget everybody else who's been on. When Bert was there, you knew it was about to happen.
There would be
I'm sure tens of thousands of stories of a kind gesture. I mean, I know dozens myself. Just a kind, quiet, off-the-record gesture from Bert to another performer, whoever they are, whatever, you know, whether it's across theatre or television or radio. And I think you add up those tens of thousands of gestures privately that we will probably never know completely, and the things that he did for decades publicly, and I think that's what gives someone legend status.